Hey dolls! So today I'm going to be sharing with you 5 kind of quick and easy ways to style a clip-in ponytail extension. I recently got this one from VP Fashion. You guys have heard me talk about them many times before. If you guys want to get your hands on any of their extensions or just anything on their site, you can use the coupon code right across the screen right here. It'll save you some money. No pressure. Do it. Don't do it. I don't care. I'm about helping you guys save some money, so go for it. If not, I'm not too worried about it. Also, this video is sponsored by VP Fashion, but I have been using their hair extensions for quite some time now, and I love them so much. I 100% recommend them, hands down. I think every pair of hair extensions that I've had, whether it be a ponytail clip-in or just clip-in extensions in general, I have pretty much always used VP Fashion, and I have never had an issue with them. I've dyed them a couple times myself. As you can see, I used my hair dye to dye this extension to match my hair. It came blonde, but I colored it myself. So if you're someone who has kind of more colorful hair and you want some volume or length, I definitely recommend VP Fashion because they have the blonde extensions that you can dye to match your own hair. These are Indian Remy extensions, so they are real. So you can dye them, you can curl them, you can crimp them, whatever your heart's desire. But anyway, that's not the point. The point is, how can you style one of these clip-in ponytail extensions? This is my first time having one of these, and I was playing around with some styles the other day. I figured that this would be a pretty good video to do for you guys in case you were kind of curious on the ways that you can style one of these, because a lot of people think, oh, it's just a ponytail extension. Yeah, it's a ponytail extension, but you can do plenty of different styles with it. It's not strictly just for a ponytail. So as you can see, here is my natural hair in all of its pink glory. I really wish my hair did grow in this color. That would be great. Just like I wish my nails were naturally painted pink and never chipped off. That would be awesome. But back to reality, that doesn't happen. So that's where things like this come into play. If you want some extra added volume and length, these are a great option. Now, what I have not done yet is trim mine to kind of fit my hairstyle. So as you can see, when I hold this up, it's a lot more long and it's not really layered, whereas my natural hair, I have it cut in layers, so it's kind of choppy. I'm not sure if I want to leave this as is or cut it down or trim it down to match my hair, but that is definitely an option. But anyway, how this basically works is you just put your hair in a basic ponytail, you guys can see, and then this little black clip on the top right up here will clip into the top. You just kind of like slide it. It's not really a clip. I shouldn't call it a clip. It's kind of just like a little comb, like a little baby comb, and you just kind of put it in there as if it's like a little barrette. You're just kind of like putting snugly into place. So you just kind of pop the comb right there into the top of the ponytail, and then the part right here is actually Velcro along with this extra little piece right here. So what you do is you just match those up. You want to take this long piece and kind of wrap it underneath all of the rest, and then simply Velcro it to the top. So you're just basically wrapping around itself and then securing it down with the Velcro. And then you take this whole chunk right here, this extra piece, and you just continue to wrap it around that part so it hides the seam, is what I like to call it, the little seam where all of the pieces are kind of sewn into place. Wrapping this around just kind of secures it, kind of hides all of the messiness. And then once you have it all the way wrapped around, you just take a bobby pin and then just pin it into place. And just like that, you have yourself a longer, fuller, fluffier, more voluminous ponytail. And you can either do just a basic ponytail, like a low ponytail, like on the top of your crown ponytail, or you can even do like a super high up, like I Dream a Genie and stuff, just kind of like all on the top of your head, like Spice Girl 90s status and stuff. It's quite fun to just kind of play around with. Also, if you find that your extensions are a little bit shinier than your natural hair, that is the problem that I have been having lately, you can take some baby powder, just some white baby powder, and kind of sprinkle it on and then maneuver it around with your hands, and that'll dull down some of the shine. Now for the second style. Very simply, you can just take all of this hair in your hand and just kind of like twist it like so, and then just start wrapping it around itself just like this to create a big full bun. And then you would do the same thing and just secure it down with some bobby pins. And once you have your bun, you can definitely cutesify it with some bow accessories. So you can do like little clip-in bows like in the front or even like in the back, like right there. That would be really cute as well. Or you can even take some of these headband type bows and just kind of secure that on and just give it a little bit more of a fun look. And then you can coordinate your accessories with whatever color outfit you're wearing. For the third hairstyle, you can do a half up, half down kind of thing. So you could just brush through, kind of go like right where your ears are, and just pull and separate your hair. So there is a top half and a bottom half. And then just brush through all of the little bumps. You guys pretty much know how to do this though. And I'm going to make mine towards the top of my head. So I'm going to keep pulling this upward and smoothing out as I go. And usually I will do this if my hair is curled or wavy. It just gives it kind of a little extra texture. So feel free to do that. But you can see my natural hair. You can see its length. I'm going to leave that part down. And then I'm going to take a hair tie and just tie this. And then I'm going to pull it up and tighten. So just pulling it even more towards the top of my head so it looks something like that. Apply this little clip-on ponytail just like I did before. Now obviously you can see like my ponytail is just about as long as my natural hair, so you could leave it like this, but what I'm going to do is do that bun just like last time, except before I do this I'm going to take the end of this little kind of teasing comb brush and I'm just going to go underneath my hair like this and gently kind of pull it up to create a little bit of volume right here, so it just kind of poofs up just a little bit, just to create a little bit of extra added poofy volume in the front right there. And then I'm gonna pull down some of my bangs just to kind of help frame my face a little bit. And then I'm going to kind of twist this and wrap it around itself just like we did with that other bun before. And then secure the bun down with some bobby pins, just like before. And I would definitely, instead of leaving my hair straight like this, I would typically, you know, curl this or wave it so it appeared to be a little bit more full, as well as maybe add in some extensions on this bottom part. The next hairstyle is pretty easy. You just wanna gather your hair all the way on one side, just like this, and use a hair tie to make a ponytail, just like so. And I like to kind of leave some of my bangs and floof up the rest of my hair, and then pop in this little extension piece, which I'm gonna do it just like the last time. I'm gonna use the little clip and go underneath of the hair. And then once you have all of the hair, you can just wear it like this. That is very easy peasy. Of course, instead of just leaving this as is, I'm going to section it into three parts. And as you guys may have guessed, I'm going to braid this. I'm not gonna show you guys step by step how I braid because there are 1,000 tutorials about it on YouTube. So if you're not sure on how to do a basic braid, you can definitely go check out tons of those other videos. But I'm just doing a basic, normal braid all the way down. And I'm gonna use a little tiny one of these hair ties. I have a whole bunch of these. You can get these at like Dollar Tree. They come in fun different colors and stuff. But I'm going to go ahead and add this to the bottom to just secure it down in place. And also I want to mention that you could get a second ponytail extension and do like braids on both sides, or like space buns, just like we did before, but like bigger, and one on each side. You could definitely go crazy with these things and just play it up and make it your own. So here you can see my side braid goes all the way down, so you can leave it as is, or what I like to do is definitely just pull it apart and make it a lot more loose and Elsa-ish, I guess you could say. So this is kind of an Elsa side braid hair tutorial in a way. So if you want to be Elsa from Frozen next year for Halloween, here's your little quick tip costume DIY. And then I'm just gonna kind of turn it this way. And then at this point you could add cute little hair gems or flowers throughout, just to give it a little bit more of a feel. If you added flowers to it, you could be more like Rapunzel from Tangled. Or you could also did like we did before and add like a flower crown or like a little hair bow. I love just adding little hair bows like this because it gives it just a fun, cute little style. So you could do this as well. And the last hairstyle would be to just take this braid as is, so that's half of the style, and then just start wrapping it around itself to create a fun little braided side bun, and again securing with bobby pins. And this side bun might take a few more bobby pins to secure because it is a little bit bigger. But as you can see, this bun is quite a bit fuller and has a little bit more dimension to it because of the braids. And again, with this, you can just add a cute little bow in the side of it to make it look a little bit more finished. And that is that for this quick, simple, easy how to style a clip-in ponytail extension. I really hope you guys do enjoy this video, or did enjoy this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up. If this is the first video that you've seen from me and you are new to my channel, feel free to hit the subscribe button so you will not miss out on future content of mine. And with that, I'm gonna go ahead and let you guys go. I hope you all enjoyed this, like I said before. And I will talk to you all next time. And don't forget to use my coupon code on vpfashion.com if you're interested in getting some hair extensions for yourself. I will talk to you all soon, hopefully. All right, so long, stay strong, stay true, and be you. All right, bye.